In this video, I just want to give an update of where I am in my Temple Run type game. So I've got now where you can only turn when you get to the turns. So if I try to turn before that, I can't. I've got the... In Temple Run, I've played it on my phone. And it's got where you lean the phone to go to either side of the path. Well, I've got that with the right stick. You can go 1 meter to either side of the middle of the path. And if you try to turn early, you can't turn early yet. You can still go off the end of the path, and then you'll never be able to turn if you miss your turn. That's where I am so far. So what I've got is a logic cube at each of the turns. So I'm designing this all on the ground. My next idea is to delete all the land and use my infinite world, infinitely spawning platforms system that I've shown in a different tutorial to spawn the pathway, and then when it turns to place a logic cube at each turn like this. Each of the logic cubes, it just says add this logic cube to a global object set called turning point. That's all that each of those have on them. I've changed the running guy's brain a little bit since last I showed. So first we go to, I can't remember exactly what I showed in my last video, so we have the setup where I set each of my vectors. I believe I showed that before. The canny turn, I set that boolean to true by default. And the position at last turn is something I'll set each time he turns, but we'll just start it wherever his position is when the game begins. Next, I call, I've got a page for debug information, so I show his forward vector and its current position at the top of the screen. And so when I finally publish the game, I will either ignore that line or just take this page out. So now I've simplified his turning system a little bit. When he can turn, and I started to press the left stick to the right direction, I call turn right. And when he can turn, and I press it to the left direction, I call turn left. And then this else means when can turn is false, it waits 1 second, and then it makes it true again. So again, he can only turn after basically once per second. And then after that, the right stick, he can move with strafing left and right, so that lets him move back and forth on the path. And then, so when he's going north or south, I clamp his X position to the position at the last turn, it's X plus or minus 1. When I'm going east or west, I clamp the Z direction plus or minus 1 from where he last turned. And so that's what keeps him able to do that on my phone, is the tilt to go back and forth, and then I will reset this position at last turn every time he turns. And then we have move constantly, and then the rest of the brain, I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it yet, so I just put in done executing, so the rest of that is skipped for now. So I think I've shown everything except the turning. So here's turn right. When it detects a turning point, so I have to be close enough to a turning point that the player's detect sphere can see it, and I've really scaled that way down from what it originally was. I set this position at last turn equal to the position of the turning point, logic cube. And then when the distance to it is less than 2, then I go ahead and do my turn to the right, and then I say that can turn equals false. Okay, and the same for the left. I'm going to switch back and forth between these pages. You can see they're exactly the same, except that to the left has negative 90 instead of regular 90. And so that's my progress so far. So he'll move along the path, and then when he's within 2 meters of a logic cube, then he'll be able to turn, and so he can go around the path. So that's my progress so far. Next, I'm going to work on probably spawning these logic cubes and spawning the pathway that I'm going to run. I'm going to build it with platforms first, and then when I get that system down, I'm going to replace the platforms with temporary terrain being generated. So that's my progress.